As just now we have studied about moment of inertia of some standard object about their central axis of rotation. Now, if moment of inertia is required for some different axis of rotation, we use axis theorem. We can also write for moment of inertia calculation about different axis of rotation other than standard central axis of rotation, we use axis theorems, and there are two axis theorems which I written as the very first one as perpendicular axis theorem and the second one is parallel axis theorem. Let's discuss both of these axis theorem one by one in detail. So, first we'll discuss about perpendicular axis theorem. And for perpendicular axis theorem, you always need to keep one point in mind, that is, this theorem is applicable only for laminar bodies which are having two dimensional structures. Laminar bodies are those which are two dimensional structured bodies which are not having any thickness. For a laminar body, let us first define this perpendicular axis theorem and later we analyze how the theorem is derived. Say we are having a plate like structure or which is having a negligible thickness like this. And from any point within the body, if we consider an axis of rotation which is perpendicular to the plane of this body, say it is written as the axis ZZ dash. And if we rotate the body about this axis of rotation and say its moment of inertia we are getting is IZ. Now, from the same point from which ZZ dash axis is passing, if we consider another axis in the plane of body and say this YY dash. So, this is an axis which is perpendicular to the axis ZZ dash and is also lying in the plane of the body. If we rotate the body about this axis of rotation and say the moment of inertia of body is IY. And we consider the third axis which is also in the plane of body and passing through the same point of intersection of body with ZZ dash axis and YY dash axis, and the third axis we consider which is perpendicular to both of these axes and say this XX dash axis. And say we rotate the body about this axis and say the moment of inertia value we are getting is IX. Then we can write according to perpendicular axis theorem, we use IZ is equals to IX plus IY. This is the statement of perpendicular axis theorem, or we can write this as the expression by which we can relate the moment of inertia for a given body which is laminar or two dimensional structure, their moment of inertia is about the three perpendicular axes, two of which should lie in the plane of body and the third one is perpendicular to this. So, this theorem states that sum of the two perpendicular axes of rotation lying in the plane of body is equal to the third perpendicular axis which is perpendicular to the plane of body and passing through the point of intersection of the two initial axes which are in the plane. So, this is the perpendicular axis theorem expression which we use to find different type of results. let us analyze the proof of perpendicular axis theorem. Say this is the given body and we draw three perpendicular axes passing through a point of the body. Here z axis is normal to the plane of body and x and y axis are lying in the plane of body. Now in this situation, let us consider an elemental mass dm in the body. Say it is located at a distance r from the z axis. So when the body is rotated about z axis, we can say moment of inertia of body about z axis can be written as integration of dm r square. Because on rotating this mass dm, on rotating the body, this mass dm will revolve in a circle of radius r. Now say this dm is located at a distance x from the axis x x dash. In this situation, if the body is rotated about this axis of rotation, we can state this elemental mass dm will revolve in a circular path of radius x about the axis x x prime. In this situation, moment of inertia of body about this x axis can be written as integration of dm x square. Now, if we consider the distance of this mass from this y axis is to be y, then in this situation, when the body is rotated about this y axis, we can say this elemental mass dm will revolve in a circular path of radius y about the axis y y prime. So in this situation, the moment of inertia I y we can write as integration of dm y square. Now in this situation, we can use Pythagoras in these dimensions as x square plus y square is equals to r square. And we can see as here Iz is written as integration of dm r square, this can be written as integration of dm x square plus y square, which can be opened as integration of dm x square plus integration of dm y square. And we can see integration of dm x square is ix and integration of dm y square is iy. So here this iz can be written as ix plus iy. This is the way how we derived the result of this perpendicular axis theorem. Just now we have studied about perpendicular axis theorem. Let's have some applications of perpendicular axis theorem. We talked just about a ring. We know well that for the case of a ring, if it rotates about its standard central axis of rotation, which is perpendicular to the plane of ring and passing through its center, if it revolves, we know that the moment of inertia of this ring is given as mr square if r is its radius and m is the mass. Say for example, we wish to find out the moment of inertia of the same ring about its diametrical axis of rotation. For example, say we are having an axis of rotation which is passing through its diameter or passing along its diameter and the body is rotated about this axis of rotation. Then we can state the ring will be rotating like this. And in this situation, if we wish to find out its moment of inertia, let us consider it to be I. So, as for a ring, all diameters are identical. If we consider another axis, which is also passing through center and along the diameter, but it is perpendicular to the initial axis of rotation. And if body is rotated about this axis of rotation, like here, ring will rotate like this. Again, as both the axes are identical, here also moment of inertia will be I. And we can see that these are two axes which are perpendicular to each other and lying in the plane of ring. So, if we consider a third axis which is perpendicular to the plane of ring, like if I just hold this pen in this manner, so this will be the axis of rotation which is passing through center of ring and it is perpendicular to the plane also. So this will be the ring which is already we have discussed, where moment of inertia can be given as mr square. So, the sum of moment of inertia of these two axes must be equal to the moment of inertia about this axis according to perpendicular axis theorem. So, we can see according to perpendicular axis theorem, we use I plus I is equals to mr square. This I plus this I is equal to this mr square, which can be written as IC also. Like if I just draw these two axes in this plane, so one would be this and other would be this. So these are two diametrical axes of rotation which are lying in the plane of ring. These are perpendicular to each other. And the moment of inertia of the ring about these two axes is I. Then I plus I can be written as IC. So in this situation, the value of this moment of inertia we can write as half mr square. This is the moment of inertia of a ring about its diametrical axis of rotation. Here you can see we have evaluated the result by using perpendicular axis theorem very easily. Otherwise, if we would have followed the process of integration, that would be a very lengthy process if you wish. I request all students to execute it at home in a systematic way and try to evaluate the result which is comparable to this. See, if we use the similar situation for a disk, we know well that for a given disk, its moment of inertia about the central axis of rotation, which is perpendicular to the plane of disk, is given as IC is equals to half mr square. Say, we are required to find the moment of inertia of the similar disk about its diametrical axis of rotation. So, diametrical axis is the one which is along the diameter about which we can rotate the disk. Now, in this situation, if its moment of inertia is I, we can consider another diametrical axis which is passing through the center and is perpendicular to the initial axis. If we rotate the disk about this axis of rotation, again for this rotation, the moment of inertia will be I because both the axes are symmetrically uniform. And the sum of these two moment of inertia must be equal to the moment of inertia about the axis which is passing through center, which is IC. So, here again we can write, according to perpendicular axis theorem, we use I plus I is equals to IC, which can be written as half mr square. So, it is 2I is half mr square. We can write I as 1 by 4 mr square, which is the moment of inertia of a disk about its diametrical axis of rotation. Now, we can also extend the perpendicular axis of rotation concept for a thin rectangular plate. We already studied that for a thin rectangular plate, if we rotate it about a central axis of rotation which is passing through its center and lying in the plane of this axis, then we can say by using the concept of mass distribution property, its moment of inertia is exactly equal to that of the thin rod which is of length L. Say this is a plate which is of length L and it is of breadth B. We can state about this axis of rotation, its moment of inertia IC can be written as ML square by 12. Similarly, if we rotate the same plate about this axis of rotation, which is perpendicular to the initial axis passing through the center, and about this axis, its moment of inertia can be written as IC dash, which is equals to MB square by 12. Because about this side, it is equivalent to a thin rod, which is of length B. So, here moment of inertia can be written as MB square by 12. Now say for the same plate, if we rotate it about an axis of rotation which is perpendicular to the plane of this plate and passing through its center. So this is the rod of plate of length L. This is the side of plate which is of breadth B. And we consider an axis of rotation which is passing through its center and perpendicular to the plane of this plate. So we can say this is the axis which is analogous to the z direction, and about x and y directions we can consider the axis of rotation which we already discussed here. So we can talk about this axis of rotation which is having moment of inertia IC, that is ml square by 12. About this axis of rotation, it is IC dash, which is mb square by 12. So moment of inertia about the central axis which is perpendicular to the plane of this plate, we can write ICP by using perpendicular axis theorem to be equal to sum of IC and IC dash. You can also write by perpendicular axis theorem, we are writing this. So moment of inertia of the plate about an axis which is passing through the center of plate and perpendicular to the plane of plate can be given as sum of these two, which is m by 12 into l square plus b square. And the same result can be extended to a box also. So we are having a box of height h, having length l and breadth b. It is rotating about its central axis of rotation. So by using mass distribution property, we can assume that the box is made up of several thin rectangular plates of size l by b. We can say this is the same moment of inertia which is applicable for this box also.